baking, don't avoid opening and closing the oven because you're interfering with the temperatures. So the What's up guys, how are you doing? I hope you're good. I hope you're keeping safe. Welcome back to another video. Welcome back to Petite Mama YouTube channel. If you're new here guys, my name is Eunice. I'm a mom and I'm a wife, and I do videos about motherhood, lifestyle, and generally about being a wife. So on today's video guys, I'm just going to show you how to use your electric oven to bake. Generally, just when it comes to using the temperature, the time, because I feel like so many people have very good ovens, very good quality ovens, but you're using them as storage units, guys. It's high time we just learn how to make some small cakes, you know, from the comfort of our homes. And you're going to enjoy this video and you're going to see how easy it is. Don't have an excuse, guys. You don't even need those expensive tins from the supermarket to bake a cake. And I've done several videos of how to bake a simple vanilla cake or a simple banana cake. So I'm going to leave the links down on this video, so make sure to go and check them out. I'm not a pro when it comes to baking. That's why I want to share with you these videos, because I feel like my recipe is very easy, and it's very easy for someone who is starting. So first thing first is how to use your oven. So let's get to it. So what I have before me is a Mika 3G plus 1A electric oven. So I've mentioned this below, to have maximum power in your oven, it's very important to connect your oven to this lower socket. So you just need to open up the place and get an electrician to do it for you, just to be safe, because the upper area, this place does not give your oven maximum heat. So you'll find that this socket overpowered by the oven power. So it will keep on going on and off, which is not good. So first thing first is that when you have that connected over there, you come here. This is what we have here. This is time. And the good thing about time is that when you put time on, automatically the oven is on and you can see it's lighting. So you go ahead, you put your time on. And if you're baking, most cakes normally use a time that is, I'm waiting for it to focus. Most cakes use time that is 45 or 50 minutes. So you can put 50 minutes so that your oven preheats for 5 minutes or 10. So you can even start, you may start baking at the 40th minute. So go ahead and have your timer on. Know the time that you need to put. So after your time is sorted, you now need to come to the heat area, or you can even start with the heat area. So depending on where your heat nozzle is, mine is at the farthest end. So you come here and make sure that you put it on this sign that shows heat is coming from both top and bottom. So now you save. Then now this is temperature. Mine is using the degrees Celsius. And most cakes use 180 degrees Celsius. Let me just put this well. So you have to go ahead and put it at 180 degrees Celsius. And mine goes all the way up to the bottom. So my cake will be cooking at 100 degrees Celsius. If your oven is giving your temperatures at a different unit, you can go ahead and convert 180 degrees Celsius. So now I've sorted my heat and I've sorted my temperature, and your time is already going. I've put time at 50 minutes, but normally you have to preheat your oven for at least 5 or 10 minutes before putting any cake mixture in the oven. So now after that, now after opening my oven, you can see I have two rows. I can either put this a little bit higher, it's hot, a little bit higher, or I can put it at this constant level that I always use. So heat is coming from both top and bottom. So go ahead and take your baking tin and put your mixture in the middle. If you're having another cake, you can put it aside here, or if you are baking using your sufuria, go ahead and put it inside, and you'll realize that your cake is going to cook so well. So The lighting going on and off is definitely the oven controlling the heat, just like the way the fridge goes on and off. So it will do that. Don't worry about that. Don't think that, oh my God, my oven is not heating. It is definitely heating, but it's a way of controlling heat. So the light will be on and off after... I haven't monitored the time, but it just goes on and off, I think after 2 or 3 minutes. So this is how you place your baking tins in the oven and let them cook. So when you're baking, don't avoid opening and closing the oven because you're interfering with the temperatures. So the moment you put in your cake mixture, just close your oven and use this area here to observe, or let it cook for at least 30 or 20 minutes, then give it a get to check on it, and then go ahead and let it now cook until the time is completely off. So the time will always be going on. So, and then the good thing about the oven timer is that when the time is already done, it will always give you a click sound. Did you hear that? That click sound just shows you that time is over. So you can go ahead, even if you're in the sitting room or bedroom, that sound you'll be able to hear, and it will alert you that you need to check whatever you've put in the oven. So no more excuses, guys. You can use your sufuria, make your mixture, put it in the oven, and go ahead today, give it a try. Just put on the timer, put on the temperature, and put the heat, and just use your oven, guys. I'm challenging you to use your oven after using this video. Try to do something, and I'm going to leave the link of both vanilla and banana cakes that I've made. Very, very easy recipes, because I'm not a pro, so I feel like my recipes are very easy and they're very good for beginners. So go and check it out, guys. So guys, please tell me that was easy. If you feel I've not mentioned something, just leave in the comment section and I'll try give it an answer. At least if you're using the Maker 3G plus 1A like me, and I'll try answer that. But those are the three basic things that you just need when you are baking: the time, temperature, and the heat. So watch on that and give it a try, and please remember to give this video a thumbs up, and I'm going to see you in my next video. And that's it for today. Goodbye.